Comics turned to movies are one thing, and consistency with the actors is another. If you would remember all the literature characters you've seen on the big screen, I'm pretty sure you'll only remember one actor. Like Robert Downey Jr. as Iron Man, Daniel Radcliffe as Harry Potter, Brendan Fraser as Rick O'Connell, Rowan Atkinson as Mr. Bean, and the list goes on. But here's the catch. What if there are more than one actor who played the role of a main character throughout the years? That's where the whole system gets divided. Remember that web-shooting, dorky, lanky teenager that comic junkies love? Yes, we're talking about our beloved Peter Parker, our Spider-Man. The fact that there have been so many Spider-Men that played on the big screen, it kind of becomes as a blurred line whether who to choose as your favorite friendly neighborhood Spider-Man. Hey specialists, welcome back to another video. Today, we'll be talking about the famous man in his suit and mask, Spider-Man. We'll be going through the actors who play the role and give them the good ranking while dividing the reasons into two, as Peter Parker and as Spider-Man himself. Let's get into it. Number 3. Andrew Garfield. Coming in at number 3 is Toby Maguire's successor, 2012's The Amazing Spider-Man Peter Parker. Now, he has to be arguably the bad actor who played his role. Many would blame the script, but when Peter Parker looked from this to this, it definitely received a lot of criticism. To follow the iconic, nerdy-looking, goody-two-shoes innocent Peter Parker, it had to be a hard task for Andrew Garfield, primarily because he looked way too cool for the comic kid. No matter how anyone would look at him in any direction, even throwing in a pair of eyeglasses, it just won't work out. And the nerd learning to skateboard? That doesn't sound like something an actual Peter Parker would do. But many have been in favor of him going as Spider-Man. He had the right movements, coolness, and acting for a superhero, but not as a teenager. Additionally, he could have been the least favorite because of the audience expectations. The comic and movie enthusiasts have seen how Toby played out as the first Spider-Man, and they saw him good. And people knew that the next Spidey would be just as good, but poor Andrew, he just wasn't fitting for the role, as many claimed. Nevertheless, The Amazing Spider-Man still got praise for having good chemistry with a male and female lead, and a different take on the usual Spider-Man story. Number 2. Tom Holland. It has to be the most recent Spidey to be the second best Spider-Man. If you're too young, Tom Holland might have been the first Spider-Man you've known. Making Holland's first solo debut in Spider-Man Homecoming was like a breath of fresh air for most, especially after the tragic Andrew Garfield films. But let's dive further onto why he's the best. He was as smooth and cocky as Andrew Garfield's Spider-Man, and as nerdy and awkward as Tobey Maguire's Peter Parker. Many people loved him because he's an actor who's actually the right age for the role. Not too mature, not too cool, just Tom Holland in his own element. For a change, it also highlighted his struggle as a teenager, balancing his double life, trying to impress his crush without outing himself. It's all a typical teenage world. However, many people still disliked him as he played the innocent teenager role too well that he ended up doing stupid things.
Waiting for confirmation.
Confirm. Welcome to the Avengers.
But after all, he's just a child. The idea of being Iron Boy or Tony Stark's minion wasn't also something viewers enjoyed, but after all, it might be time for some change, hmm? With all that said, he definitely is a great Spider-Man actor to date, and we could possibly hear more from him, thanks to the future MCU movies. Number 1. Tobey Maguire. Being the first Spider-Man, Tobey Maguire is just really unforgettable, and earns our number 1 spot. No matter where you go, you would always remember that certain face of Peter Parker, and that's Tobey Maguire's face, and we mean quite literally, his memes are everywhere too. With the honor of being the first web-slinger to hit the big screen in 2002, he stood as the best Spider-Man for years. Tobey Maguire may have looked as great and mighty with all the praises he received. Physically speaking, critics have said he looked way too old for the role. A man on his late 20s as a high school teenager? That just doesn't fit together. But he was a great Peter Parker, that's for sure. He played the socially awkward, nerdy, shy character very well. Spider-Man tended to be different as Peter Parker. He's cocky, lovable, and energetic.
He was able to tell the perfect Spider-Man story. He was the awkward kid with superpowers who got the girl out of his league. He set the boards for the next Spider-Man, and he shone a side of Peter Parker many have remembered.
And that's it for our rating, folks. Who's the best Spider-Man for you? Let us know in the comment section below. Make sure to subscribe and turn on the notification bell. Until next time, this is your TV Specialists.